Bandaging is the process or art of applying a bandage over any part of the body. Skillful application of a bandage, which in addition to serving the purpose for which it is applied, looks neat and nice and stays in position till the next dressing, is an art every nurse should learn. In this class, we will be studying the techniques of application of the commonly used cotton roller bandages to various parts of the body. We will also look at various other types of bandages and their specific uses. The art of bandaging has been demonstrated by late Dr. M.K. Vaidya, a master surgeon who considered the art of dressing and bandaging as important as operative techniques. Let us first study the various uses of bandages. The most common use of a bandage is to hold dressings in position. Note this ulcer on the medial aspect of left ankle, covered with gauze and gamgee dressing which I am holding with my hand. Now watch the bandage as it covers and supports the dressing, holding it in place. The bandage also supports the injured part and gives it rest by restricting movements. See this sling given to the right arm, which supports the arm and shoulders and gives them rest. Bandages are used to immobilize a fractured or contused part alone or with wooden splints or plaster slabs. This girl has a fracture of forearm bones, and a temporary support is given by a bandage and splint, and another bandage hangs it to the neck as a sling. A tight bandage over a limb is often used to control hemorrhage. See this bleeding surface over the left thigh, and note how a tight bandage is given, rolled tightly to control the bleeding. An elastic bandage is used to apply pressure and reduce edema, as this ankle bandage for ankle sprain. It is also used in varicose veins to improve venous return and prevent edema of the foot. This is a bandage for varicose veins. Thus, bandages have several uses and accordingly they are made of different materials. Cotton roller bandages are the most commonly used bandages to hold dressings or splints in position. They are light and absorbent. They are also cheap and hence can be discarded after use. Gamgee bandage or cotton gauze bandage is a sandwich of cotton between two layers of gauze. They are used over large wounds with copious discharge because they can absorb large amount of discharge or pus. They are also used for pressure bandaging and under the plasters to protect the skin. Crepe bandage or elastocrepe bandage is a woven elastic fiber bandage and has elasticity. It is used to provide pressure and support to sprained ankles or to reduce edema as in varicose veins. The elastocrepe bandage can be washed, dried without squeezing and reused, but its elasticity reduces after reuse. Calico, muslin or flannel cloths are used to prepare triangular slings and many-tailed bandages for chest and abdomen. Tubular cotton bandages of various sizes are available for fixation of dressings over the limbs, fingers, scalp or trunk. The kneecap seen here is an elastic tubular bandage. Having seen the various types of bandages, let us now concentrate on cotton roller bandages, which will be testing our art of bandaging every day and on every patient. The bandages are available in different widths, ranging from 1 inch to 6 inch, that is 2.5 to 15 centimeters. You should always choose a bandage of the correct size. For fingers, use a 1-inch bandage. For wrist, hand and arm, use a 2-inch bandage. For forearm and leg, use a 3-inch bandage. For thigh, buttocks, hip spica, use a 4-inch bandage. And over the chest, breast and abdomen, use a 6-inch bandage. The aims of bandaging should always be remembered. The wound and its dressing should be completely covered by the bandage. No part of the wound should remain exposed. Number 2, the bandage should be supportive to the tissues. That is, the patient should feel comfort after the bandage. Number 3, it should also provide rest to the wounded part by obtaining and maintaining the desired position of the neighboring joints. Number 4, it should give even pressure on the wound without constricting the limb or obstructing circulation. And lastly, it should stay in place without becoming loose till the next dressing. Now let us study the general rules of the art of bandaging. First, explain the procedure to the patient to relieve his anxiety and ensure cooperation. Then collect all the required equipment near the patient on a trolley or a tray. It should include all dressing materials, kidney tray, bandage rolls of different sizes, scissors, and adhesive plaster. The patient should be in a comfortable position during bandaging, and the injured area should be well supported and in the position that is to be maintained. You should stand on the side to which the bandage has to be applied. If you are bandaging the left side, stand on the left side. If you are bandaging the right side, stand on the right side. But do not bend over the patient. The bandage should be dry. After completing the dressing of the wound, always dry the surrounding area over which the bandage will be rolled. Never apply a wet or a damp bandage, as it will shrink after drying and constrict the part. If there are bony prominences in the area of the bandage, they should be well padded with cotton to avoid friction with the bandage. This is particularly important when a splint or a plaster slab is applied. Now coming to the actual act of bandaging, it has 3 steps. Step 1, fixing the bandage. Step 2, rolling the bandage to cover the dressing. And step 3, finishing the bandage. First, select a bandage of suitable size. To bandage the right side of the patient, stand on his right side and hold the bandage in your left hand. Unroll a few centimeters of the bandage and hold the end over the outer aspect of the limb. Note that the outer surface of the bandage is applied to the skin. The starting point is just below the dressing, avoiding the joints. Roll the bandage 2 times to fix it there. If 2 complete turns are not taken, then the bandage will slip when it is pulled tight. That is why it must be fixed by taking 2 simple turns. The bandage is always rolled from below upwards and from within outwards. Rolling the bandage. Now roll the bandage to cover the entire dressing. Apply the bandage from below upwards, from within outwards, and with uniform pressure. That is, when the bandage comes in front of the limb, it should pass from within outwards. The bandage must be applied with uniform pressure, neither too tight nor too loose, and with equal pressure in each turn. Finishing the bandage. Always finish the bandage away from the wound, otherwise it will cause pain while applying and removing adhesive strips. Always finish with a straight turn and cut the extra length of the bandage. Use only as much bandage as is necessary to serve the purpose. Do not try to finish off the roll, otherwise the bandage will become too bulky. Lastly, fix the end with strips of sticking plaster or safety pin or by splitting the end and tying. Two thin strips of adhesive plaster, 2 inch long, are fixed over the end of the bandage. A 6-inch bandage may require 3 strips. One end of the adhesive strips may be folded slightly to facilitate removal. Folding the end of the bandage also makes removal easy. Tailing the bandage. Split the terminal portion of the bandage longitudinally. Take one simple knot to fix the tails to each other and then tie the tails around the limb. If the dressing is wet or likely to be soaked with discharges, then the adhesive strips will not stick, so it is better to fix it by tailing. A safety pin may be applied to the end of the bandage along with the underlying turns. While applying the safety pin, the bandage should be lifted up to protect the skin. Now let us study the 4 basic techniques of rolling the bandage. Simple spiral. Here, after fixing the bandage, it is rolled in a spiral form. Each turn covers 2/3 of the preceding turn and is parallel to it. It is rolled from narrower portion to the broader portion, that is from the distal end of the limb proximally. Reverse spiral is a modified spiral for tapering parts like forearm or legs. Here the roll is reversed downwards on itself at each turn. Note how the roll is reversed and the thumb of the left hand fixes the bandage when it is turned and rolled. The reverse spirals may be interspersed with simple spirals if you want to give a tight bandage, for example, to stop bleeding with pressure. This gives additional pressure under the turns. This was a reverse spiral followed by a simple spiral and again a reverse spiral. Figure of 8 bandage is specifically used over joints. Here the bandage is applied alternately, once above and once below the joint, crossing the joint obliquely with each turn. The loops of the bandage so formed will look like a figure of 8. The figure of 8 bandage restricts the movements of the joint on the side where the bandage crosses it. Spica. Spica is a modified form of figure of 8, used for hip, shoulder, groin and thumb. Here one loop of the 8 is large and goes around the body, while the other loop is small, turning around the limb. This is the larger loop going around the body, and this is the smaller loop going around the arm. This is shoulder spica. Removal of bandage. First, gently remove the sticking plaster or cut the knot if a knot is tied and unroll the bandage, passing it from one hand to the other and collecting it in a loose roll. Take care not to touch the dirty parts of the bandage. If the bandage shows dried discharge or blood, it may be adherent to the skin and the wound, and its removal will be painful. So soak it in water and wet it before attempting removal. And note how easily the bandage and the dressing separate from the wound after wetting with water. The most comfortable way to remove a large bandage is to cut it with a bandage cutting scissors and remove it as a single turn. The bandage cutting scissors are special angulated scissors whose lower blade is longer with a blunt rounded tip so as to protect the skin from injury. Cut the bandage over normal skin and not over the wound site. Also, cut where the bandage is thinnest and not through the dressing materials. And now see how the bandage comes out as a single layer.